I want to give some arena tips, especially for this arena map. Yeah, this week's arena map. Yeah, some players requested this, so let's do this. Okay, so this is the arena map we have right now. If we are attacking the enemy, we are going to be on the top part, the green circle. Yep. So leader will be here, and our second unit here, and our third unit here. And the enemy will be here on the bottom one. Leader, second slot, third slot. Okay. First of all, you can see here on the enemy side, on the defending side, the first unit, which is the leader, will be able to climb here with only one height. Okay. So if your character only have one jump, your character cannot climb here. Okay. So it is important. That's the basic. And then, recently, Sakura has become the new meta in arena, especially in this arena. Why? Because if I'm attacking on the solid tree here, the green circle, Sakura has move 4, which is 1, 2, 3, and then 4. Sakura will be here. And then, she will use 4 range attack, right? Tiger Tremor. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the center of the AoE, which means Sakura can hit the third slot enemy, defending enemy, right from the first act. Okay, that's the cool part about Sakura. So how to counter Sakura? Because I see a lot of people are using her. If the enemy is using Sakura here as the leader, Sakura will be able to move here. 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So to counter this Sakura, the best one is to use Shen Mei. Yep. Okay, Sakura, the enemy Sakura will be able to do 1, 2, 3, 4 Tiger Tremor to your leader. If you're using Shen Mei, and if your Shen Mei is equipped with Alkemono, your Shen Mei should be able to survive Sakura's Tiger Tremor. And then Shen Mei will move here, and then use Anchor Cast to kill Sakura. Bam! Like that. That's one of the way to counter. Okay, now what if the Sakura enemy is using Rahu on the slot 2? Okay, let's say the enemy Sakura is on the slot 3, and then when Rahu use the overclock, Sakura should be in this position, right? Move here, and then move 1, 2, 3, 4, and then can do Tiger Tremor to your ally. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then this is the center of the Tiger Tremor's AoE, which means Sakura's Tiger Tremor can hit the second enemy and the third enemy. Boom, double KO. That's the normal thing. To counter this, you can put two water units here and here. Lofia with Divine Shelter, both as Chronomancer and Magic Swordman, can endure the Tiger Tremor's damage from Sakura. And from the third slot, I usually use Selena. This is the best way to counter this Sakura. So even if the enemy is using Rahu, Overclock, and Sakura, bam! After Sakura uses Tiger Tremor here, my Selena will do Blizzard Strike, bam! 1100 damage. If Sakura is still alive, okay, Lofia will move, and maybe she's going to use Freeze, or maybe to Overclock my Selena, so that my Selena can hit Sakura once again. Boom! Sakura is dead. And then the enemies only left one Rahu and one leader. The popular meta is Dorothea here. Dorothea, Rahu, Sakura. So Dorothea will move, and then my Shen Mei will do Anchor Cast to Dorothea. Bam! Because Dorothea has higher agility, she will move first, right here. And then Shen Mei will move here, and then Anchor Cast. Bam! If Dorothea is still alive, maybe Dorothea will move once again here, and then use skill to my Lofia, most likely. But after that, Shen Mei or Selena will kill her. Now the last one will be Rahu. Rahu is actually quite dangerous in this arena because of the black hole. Lofia as Chronomancer Plus also quite dangerous because of the gravity gem. Basically the same skill but the better version of black hole. This Lofia can kill my Selena easily, Shen Mei, and maybe my Lofia too. That's depend on the RNG, I mean the agility stuffs. Okay, so back to basic again. You can make it so that your character will strike first. Okay, Let's say if the enemy is Holy Brawler with high agility, it will move first as the leader. 1, 2, 3, 4, here, the Holy Brawler. And then you, your leader, you will be able to strike this one first. Okay, so basically if your leader is, let's say, a Sage, or maybe Rin, or maybe Magic Attacker that need cast time, your Magic Attacker can move here and then cast the AoE right here on the center. And then, bam! This Holy Brawler, the enemy Holy Brawler, will get hit before it moves, yeah. The casting will be done before the enemy moves. That's one of the way. Also, if you are using the other character that can do far range AoE, such as Shen Mei, or maybe Dorothea, or maybe Shita, or maybe who else? Sangetsu! Yeah, Sangetsu is also good for this. I mean, if the enemy Holy Brawlers here, 4 move, right? And then your Sangetsu will move here. If you equip your Sangetsu with anti-missile pendant or maybe snowman hat, your Sangetsu will be able to do Dragon Slayer, like 4 range. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, Dragon Slayer can hit the enemy right from the first strike. If the enemy is green element, let's say Yomi or Lucian, that will be one hit kill by Sangetsu. Boom! Now, after you kill this enemy, you are going to be like 3 versus 2. And most likely you are going to win. That's one of the strategy. Okay, the other strategy is, yeah, of course, back to basic. If the enemy are using all fire, the best way is to counter with full water. That's the basic one. But you have to count, yeah, the turn, the agility. Read the enemy's agility. Like, are you going to hit them first? Are the enemy going to hit you first? You can count that. Yeah, you can do some simulation in your head before you attack the enemy. However, calculation still sometimes can be so wrong. For example, so if the enemy is using Sakura right here on the third enemy, and then you might want to avoid Sakura, or you want to hit Sakura first, and then you are planning to hit Sakura with your second unit. Okay, let's say your second unit will move here, and you are hoping that the enemy Sakura won't hit you. But too bad, Sakura will move here 1, 2, and then 3 here, and then we'll use Tiger Tremor 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the center of the AoE, which means Sakura still can hit your character here. So that's not a good idea. So this kind of thing is actually very crucial. I mean, whatever character you use, it's going to be good if you can do simulation before you do the attack. Also, Quicken is very good for Arena. I mean, for example, my Selina has Quicken, the enemy Selina doesn't have Quicken. My Selina can do attack twice before the enemy try to attack me, and that will give me higher damage, which means can give me victory. That's also very important. And the other strategy is to use Machinist. Well, it is depend on your enemy actually. If your enemy is using something that can kill your Machinist easily, do not do it. Yeah, try to look at their agility, and then try to count if the enemy can kill you or not. Yeah. So let's say I'm using a Machinist. Machinist normally has 3 moves. So if I put my Machinist on the third slot, my Machinist will move here. Right? Before my Machinist move here, if I put a Chronomancer here, the Chronomancer might going to overclock this character, this Machinist. And then the Machinist will move once again here, and then do Bombshell. Bombshell's attack range is 4 and 5-5 diamonds. So the Bombshell's attack range will be 1, 2, 3, 4 here. And you can do double KO here. Yeah, you can hit these two enemies, basically, if you are using Machinist and Overclock. That's one of the other strategy. And the other tips, yeah, let's say this is the last tip for this video because it is already too long. If your enemy is using a Chronomancer here, and if you want to fight the enemy with another Chronomancer, make sure that your Chronomancer has higher agility. That's very important. Because if your Chronomancer has higher agility, your character will be able to move twice first before your enemy move twice and kill your squad. Okay? If the enemy move twice and then kill your Chronomancer, your character will never move twice. It will only stop here. Or maybe getting killed by the enemy. And then your Chronomancer do overclock to nothing. And that's going to be a mess. If this happen, you will lose. 100% lose. Because you only have one hitter and one Chronomancer. Well, you still can win if you are lucky. I mean, your Chronomancer suddenly use Black Hole to the enemy. Bam! The enemy died. So you are 2 versus 2 and then you are lucky with the charge time. I mean, your Chronomancer use Black Hole to the enemy before they kill your Chronomancer. Yeah, you still can win, but that's going to be quite hard. You need luck for that. But yeah, okay. So those are the tactics for this arena. So I think that's all for now. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe now if you haven't. And see you again next time. Bye bye. The Alchemist Code. Punch.